Next, the fourth track, which is about Islamic studies. Okay, so it's a very interesting topic on the study on early Islamic engineering, no, by Muhammad Taqiyuddin. Muhammad?
Yes, I am here. Can everyone hear you here? Yes, good,
Hello?
thanks. Yes, hello.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, my turn. Thanks for moderator, for other participant, and my new friend in this agenda. Here I want to like some about Islamic engineering. What must we understand about this topic? Next slide. The first, how the question and the first question is, what is the purpose of civil engineering in Islam? Here we focus on Islamic engineering in historical context. The first is human needs in Islam. They are ibadah or worship, maybe. Next. This is the first. So next, there's a second second need in Islam, the maqasid syariah. With this, the maqasid syariah is prevention of the fight, the prevention of the intellect and the life and the world and the others. Based on two point, the engineering in Islam was developed. Next slide. Okay, next. Thank you. The first, human welfare. Human welfare, as we understand here, is doing the job easily. So if we see the manuscript of Al-Jazari, we focus on three figures. The first is Al-Jazari, so Banu Musa and the Khalif Al-Muradi. These three person is the early engineering in Islam, early scientist in engineering in Islam. So I read and I like this manuscript which I found in online because this during COVID, the most of library in international library I find their manuscript was preserved online. So we see here animal power for water rising is one of the engineering Islam. So next, we see also this is the primary and. So next, the tertiary, human trends. When we see human trends here, the Al-Jazari make and a good creativity here. Elephant clock. When we see this elephant clock, every of this figure in elephant clock was represent of very much of civilization. Which join with the Islamic civilization and at that day. Then we see here phoenix on the top of the clock. This represent ancient civilization. So we also see the dragon, the represent of Chinese civilization. And also we see the elephant. We see the elephant is representing the civilization. So in Islamic engineering, they also the rich all and enrich the creation with integration of civilization. Next, here I make the list of manuscript and early generation in Muslim scientists. We see here Banu Musa at 7th and 8th century. Of Masehi, his manuscript is Kitab Al-Hiyal Al-Handasiyah, this in written in Arabic. So Al-Jazari, Kitab Fi Ma'rifah Al-Hiyal Al-Handasiyah, the book of knowledge and indigenous mechanical device. Last of that, Ibn Khalaf Al-Muradi. These three figure was the primary figure on if you want to understanding Islamic engineering. Who is Banu Musa? We see Banu Musa is not a one person, but he is a three brother, three famous brother in the Abbasid area, and Abbasid era, Abbasiyah. So it is Musa bin Sakir, Ahmad bin Musa, and so on. At next, we see the Banu Musa works. Next slide. The Banu Musa works, the important is the automatization. Automatization of here is the oil and lime. The automatic lamp which not need to we pour in it on the oil, but it's automatically fire take the whole from the oil from the whole to establish the fire. So the person in that time see that that swap not need the not need the fire is not need the oil, but really it is oil need for the oil, of course. Next. Yes. There's also Al-Jazari. His full name is Al-Jazari, but in Zaman Abdul Aziz Ismail Al-Jazari, he read the book Kitab Al-Hiyal Al-Handasiyah. This means in English indigenous scientist. Buku-buku unik atau teknik tentang engineering. That's in Indonesia we say. Next, we will see his work. What is the primary of his work? We can find that the main illustration, the water pump, the yearly water pump, which opposed with cylinder and double action here, as what is we find in modern era of water pump here. So, also the last figure we see, Ibn Khalaf al-Muradi, he is Spanish because he lived in Cordoba in Umayyad dynasty. His work was just now discovered in 1917 entitled in Kitab al-Asrar. Kitab al-Asrar fi nata'ij al-afkar. This is was transcript and translate to English to the word title the Book of Secret. Next slide we see the fragment of manuscript by Al-Muradi, Kitab al-Asrar fi nata'ij al-afkar. This is English translation which the project is founded by Qatar Library and Qatar Foundation to what is to reconstruct the Al-Jazari's, the Al-Muradi engineering and their contribution. Maybe this only this, only I can be speak here to be a presentation. Thanks a lot. May this agenda be success. Love no best. Thanks for the moderator and the other participants.
Hey, thank you, Muhammad, for your presentation. No? Study on early Islamic engineering. So you use qualitative descriptive method yes. On exploring your primary sources. Okay, so what do you think is the value of your paper, of your study? What value that does it give to Islamic engineering?
Yes, I here to insist to focus how we must nowadays to resurrect to reconstruct the early manuscript of science. When we see this nowadays science, we can trace. We must to trace back these roots in what era the science. It's firstly developed. If I here to notice here, the early Islamic engineering was not only not developed in a zero condition, they also adopt and they integrate from the early civilization such as Persia, India, also in Greek, the ancient Greek, which they that early civilization. They use almost of their technology, use water for the what is it for the energy, the water energy. So we can conclude here the early civilization before us, they understand that the sustainable development for their engineering. I notice here.
So do you mean that even before, no, even before our ancestors, no, have been already doing something to about sustainability, right?
Yes. Yes, this value of can we trace back and can we understand. So now can we need a collaboration between Muslim and non-Muslim and other world to develop any, I see the sustainable development based of engineering. I see this agenda is was we see in this world now.
Yes, yes. Now we have the UNSDG agenda, right? And sustainability is a must. Okay, so do you still have any more questions about the presentation of Muhammad? Okay, why did you choose these particular figures in your study? Because you made mention of three figures, right, in your study. Why yes. did you choose these three figures?
Thank you for the question from Mrs. Santi Rahmawati. Here I choose a three figure here because based on their manuscript which can be saved in Word, because the other manuscript, the another manuscript was can be traced back. Yeah, of course in Indonesia there's no access to the manuscript, the yearly manuscript of scientific manuscript in larger database in international, but I can only trace three figure about three manuscript. But in Khalif al-Muradi, the third figure, the manuscript was very very rarely, only one translation in English, but I can access to, but only can access some figure about that manuscript. So this study is need to be deeply concerned. Thanks.
Okay, thank you for that. So the as I was reading your abstract, no, it's really you are really want to know about Islamic engineering. Are you an engineer, Muhammad?
No, not in not in action, but we had the engineering it's in language because okay. Yes, deep in Arabic and
you're an engineer in
manuscript.
Language.
Yes, historical context.
Historical context. Okay, so if we don't have any more questions, you can go to our last presenter for this morning, for this conference, of course. It's the last but not the least, no? So this is about, you're talking about sustainability, Muhammad, and the next, the last, no, presenter is about sustainable development. No? So the topic is analysis of